In this video, I'm going to discuss about folded mountains. Folded mountains are formed due to the folding of crustal rocks by compressive forces generated by endogenetic forces coming from within the earth. So these are the highest mountains and the most extensive mountains in the world and are found in all the continents. So the distributional pattern of these folded mountains over the globe denotes the fact that they are generally found along the margins of the continents. Either they are in the position of north-south direction or east-west direction. So now let's see the characteristics of folded mountains. So the age of folded mountains, they are the youngest mountains on the earth's surface. So example, Himalayas is one of the examples for the folded mountains. The rocks, these rocks are formed by argillaceous rocks of folded mountains contain marine fossils. So argillaceous rocks. Argillaceous rocks are aquatic rocks which is formed in ocean, lakes. So in these regions they are formed. They contain marine fossils. So these argillaceous rocks are formed in oceans. So how these rocks are formed due to sedimentation, continuous sedimentation took place in the oceans. Marine fossils found in the rocks could survive only in the shallow sea water. So the organisms which were there in these sedimentary rocks, so the marine organisms which were there, they were able to survive only on the shallow sea water. They were able to survive only in the shallow sea water. But due to the sedimentation, these marine fossils sedimented continuously. Sedimentary overload took them to a deeper depth. So the sedimentation took place in the shallow sea water. Subsidence, increasing in sedimentary load led to subsidence and consolidation. So as the sedimentary load was increasing, this led to sedimentation, subsidence and consolidation. The sediments are found in greater depths. So from the outer, from the earth's surface, in the marine region, the sediments came and they got deposited. The sediment got deposited. The shallow regions it got deposited. Finally, the sedimentary load increased. As the sedimentary load increased, got subsided. The sedimentary load subsided to a deeper depth and they consolidated and they had many fossils inside in it. So due to the subsidiation, actually these marine organisms, they were able to live only in the shallow seawater, not in the depth of the oceans. Length and width of the folded mountains, they extend for greater lengths. So the length of the, when we see the length of the folded mountains is much higher, whereas when we see the width of these folded mountains, they are narrow. The width is narrow, but then in the length, when we see, it's very, very high. But width are smaller and narrow. Example, Himalayas length is 2400 kilometer, width is only 400 kilometer. Which shows that they are formed from shallow, long, narrow seas. Shape of these folded mountains are generally found in arc shape. So they are like arc shapes, and one side, so it has one side concave shape, the other side is convex shape. So other side is with convex slope. And location, found along the margins of the continents facing ocean. Example, Rockies, Andes and Himalayas. When we consider Himalayas, we have to take the Tethys Sea. As the Tethys Sea was there earlier in the ancient period, so when we consider Tethys Sea, Himalayas also is located along the margins of the continents facing ocean. Direction, so most of the folded mountains are in the direction of north-south direction. Example, Rockies and Andes. And west-east direction, which is example, is Himalayas, Alps. Classification. So on the basis of nature of folds, they are classified into simple folded mountains with open folds, complex folded mountains. Simple folded mountains, so they have well developed anticlines and synclines. So they are anticlines. This is anticlines, this is synclines. So this is anticline, this is syncline. And folds in wave-like pattern with simple open folds. So they are in wave-like pattern. Complex folded mountains, these structure with intensively compressed folds. So they are very compressed. So very much compressed, intensively compressed folds. And these are called a nape. Classification on the basis of age factor. process. So this is a classification on the basis of age factor. So the first one is process of mountain building is very slow and denudational process starts in the beginning, so it's difficult to classify them. So but they are classified into young folded mountains and mature folded mountains. So on the basis of age factor, they are classified into young folded mountains. They are least affected by denudation, because this, as they are saying that these are least affected by denudation because it's formed in the during the tertiary period. During the tertiary period, say Himalayas, it's a young folded mountain. But it is difficult to say that denudation process starts in the beginning itself, and it is difficult to classify because before the mountain building starts, the denudation process is already happening. So it's difficult to classify young folded mountains as they are based on the denudational process. And mature folded mountains have monoclinal ridges and valleys. So they have monoclinal ridges. So it is steep. The other one is gentle slope. So this kind of and valleys. So these mature folded mountains are intensively compressed folded mountains. On the basis of period of origin, they can be classified into old folded mountains and new folded mountains. Old folded mountains are originated before tertiary period, and they are originated in the Caledonian or Hercynian period and come under this category. And they are denuded and become relict folded mountains. For example, Aravallis in India. New folded mountains originated during the tertiary period. Example, Himalayas, Alps, Andes. These are examples of new folded mountains. So these Himalayas, Alps, Andes, these have sedimentary rocks which are more prone to denudational process than these Aravallis, which is a relict mountain.